From the tangy bite of a piece of fruit to the caustic liquids used to clear a clogged sink, acids are a type of chemical that could be found in many different aspects of our daily lives. But what is it about acids that makes some safe to eat and others dangerous? When talking acids, we're going to be talking hydrogen. Not the gas, but rather the hydrogen ion H+. This is a hydrogen atom that has lost its one and only electron. All acids produce H+ ions when dissolved in water, but it's how much H+ a specific acid can produce in water that will determine whether it can be safely eaten or not. But how do we conceptualize and measure H+ concentration? Søren Sørensen, a Danish chemist, pondered this question when he worked at the laboratories of a commercial brewery in Copenhagen. It was in 1909 that he developed a method of quantifying acidity, what is now known as the pH scale. His scale works by simply converting the concentration of hydrogen ions in a solution to a number between 0 and 14. If a chemical is acidic, then its pH will always be below a 7 on the scale. The lower the number, the higher the hydrogen ion concentration. The pH scale is a logarithmic one, meaning that one unit difference on the scale, say from 3 to 2, means a tenfold difference in H+ concentration. But 0 to 7 is only half of the picture. So what about all these numbers above 7? Substances that correspond with this half of the scale are called bases, and they are the chemical opposites of acids. The 7 on the scale represents neutral pH, what would be perfectly pure water. Like acids, bases are found in chemicals that we encounter in our everyday lives. Cleaning products such as ammonia and baking soda are bases, as are some simple medicines like milk and magnesia. They're bitter to the taste and often slippery to the touch, kind of like soap. Even though bases are different than acids, they too can be strong or weak, and a strong base can be just as dangerous and corrosive as a strong acid. Chemically, the difference between acids and bases is that acids produce hydrogen ions and bases accept them. In water, acids produce H+ ions and bases produce OH negative ions. In reactions between acids and bases, hydrogen ions will react with hydroxide ions to make water. This type of chemical reaction is called a neutralization reaction. Acids and bases are also very important in biochemistry. Many biological processes are sensitive to the pH of the surroundings, so controlling acidity in the body is crucial. Some biologically important molecules like amino acids have dual personalities. They're said to be amphoteric, which means that they can act as both acids and bases. An amino acid has a carboxylic acid group that can produce hydrogen ions, and an amino group that can accept hydrogen ions. Acids and bases are all around us, and can vary greatly in terms of their use and their nature, but they all involve hydrogen ions being passed around. Thanks for watching. If you would like to learn more chemistry basics, make sure to check out these other interesting videos in the series.